tiptoe through the window, by the window. That is where I'll be. Come tiptoe through the tulips with me.
What's going on, peeps? Today we are going to be talking about Insidious 3. I recently had the opportunity to go ahead and see this in the theater, and I really wanted to kind of give my opinion on what I thought of the film and give you a proper review. Now, my reviews are a little bit different than a lot of the reviews you will see online. I'm not going to really give you a synopsis. I'm not really going to give you any kind of plot details or anything like that. That's not really what I want to do. I just want to give my overall opinion as to what I thought of the film. I am a huge horror film fan. Insidious is, the first one, is one of my favorite horror films in the last like 10, 15 years. I really thought it was well done. I liked part two. If I had my YouTube channel when part one and two came out, part one would have definitely received a 9 as far as my review score. Part 2 would have received an 8. I didn't think it was bad, but I didn't think it was as good as part 1. But I thought it was a worthy sequel, and I liked the way it linked to part 1. Part 3, well, before I give the score, let me just say some of the things I loved about the film. First of all, what I did like about the film is it's a totally different story. It takes place before the events of part one and two, but what it does really brilliantly, I think, is it still manages to link itself to that story. The story in part one and two are done, they're over with. There's really nothing to go back to as far as what happened with that family, but in part three, they still manage to have some kind of links to what happened in the first two films, which I loved. This film was not directed by James Wan. In fact, it was directed by the guy who had written those films, Insidious 1 and 2. I guess he was a co-writer with James Wan. I'm not too sure if he did it all himself. But anyway, Lee Whannell, I believe his name is, he did a pretty good job as far as the feel of the film. It definitely kind of felt like the first two Insidious films, but there's something missing. I don't know if it's maybe just because it's a different family and a different kind of environment. I don't know if it's his directing style. I don't know if it maybe just it's the story. They wanted to go a little bit, you know, change it up a little bit, but there definitely is a difference as far as how he builds the tension compared to how it was done when James Wan was directing. Now, I know immediately a lot of people, they want to go ahead and compare James Wan to him and to this current film. And I think it's a little bit unfair because I know if I was taking over a franchise as far as directing it is concerned, and especially a successful one from someone else, I'm going to want to put my own stamp on it, make my own mark. Unfortunately, when actors or directors or authors try to do something like that, or even in the video game world, a lot of times they get unfairly criticized for not really doing it exactly the same way. But then they get criticized anyway, even if they've managed to kind of recreate what the original developers had intended. Yeah, that was my cat. Anyway, given that, I think we need to look at the director and say, okay, this is what he meant to do, and this is the direction that he meant to go, and kind of respect that. With that said, it's not as good as the first two films. It's a good film. I think it's a decent horror film on its own merits, but it's not quite as good as what James Wan had done. I just think it's done. Insidious should be finished. I thought this was a decent sequel to the, you know, to end the trilogy. But in the end, I just feel like we've already gotten enough of that world and that whole thing. With that said, I want to kind of just say overall, I thought it was a pretty good horror film. If you've never seen Insidious 1 or 2 and just happen to be able to get part three. You can watch part three. In fact, I think you could probably watch all of them, even in different orders if you want. If you wanted to watch three first, then two, then one, you probably would be able to. I would advise, though, you see part one before you see part two. I thought that the acting in this film was actually surprisingly good. I liked this actress that we saw as pretty much the victim of everything, Stephanie Scott. I thought she did a really good job. She was very vulnerable, much more vulnerable than you typically see people in these kind of films. And again, I don't want to give anything away as far as the plot is concerned. Lin Shaye, who was in Insidious 1 and 2, I think she shined. I think she was spectacular in this film. I really thought for a horror film, this kind of had a lot more emotion and a lot more feeling than even the first two Insidious films. And that kind of surprised me, and I kind of liked it. And especially, I think she did a wonderful job portraying Elise once again in this film. And if you like the first two films, I would definitely recommend to see Insidious Chapter 3. I do hope that this is the last Insidious film. I know it's a cash cow, and I hope they don't turn it into anything more than what it's already done. The Conjuring, I thought, was a really good film, and then they kind of screwed it up with Annabelle. So I kind of hope now, if they do another Insidious, they wait a couple of years, you know, like 5 or 6 years, and just move into something else. I love the supernatural stuff. I love the haunted stuff. But I think this particular franchise, for the time being, has run its course, and I don't think we need any more of them. But if you're into horror films and if you like the first two films, definitely check it out. Overall, I'm going to give this movie a 7.5 out of 10. It's a fair score. It's a pretty good horror film. It's not the greatest, nor is it the scariest, but it does have its moments, and it's definitely worth a watch. Thank you once again for watching. If you enjoyed this video and other videos, please don't forget to click subscribe on the screen and tune in for more videos. Thanks again for watching. Mastermind out.